Good afternoon. Thank you for tuning in to Mirror Now. I'm Marthy Subramaniam. And our top story this afternoon, Rajinikanth's much-anticipated political launch on the 31st has been called off after the superstar cited health reasons for calling off his political plunge. Rajinikanth, remember, was discharged from a Hyderabad hospital on Sunday after being treated for blood pressure fluctuations. In an open letter, Rajinikanth has said that his crew members testing positive on the film set was a sign from God. Now, this comes a month after he said he will float his own party and face the 2021 Tamil Nadu Assembly elections. He has, however, said he will continue to serve the people in whatever way he can without entering electoral politics. My colleague Shilpa joins us live from outside Rajinikanth's residence. First of all, Shilpa, what is the sense over there? Are there some fans who have already gathered, supporters who are disappointed, or is it just an empty place outside Rajinikanth's residence? Secondly, just take us through some points of what he mentions in that letter. Does he say he's never going to take an electoral plunge again, or is it something that he's putting on hold for now?
Well, Aarti, just to give you a sense of what exactly is happening outside superstar Rajinikanth's residence at this point, we're not seeing a lot of fans. This is, of course, in stark contrast to the day when he put out the tweet saying that he will be launching his political party in January 2021. On that day, we saw a large number of fans gathering outside his residence and cheering and raising slogans and celebrating, in fact. But today, not a lot of fans have come because, of course, this decision has caused them a lot of disappointment. Superstar Rajinikanth took to Twitter a few minutes back and he said that he will not be entering electoral politics and he will not be launching his political party, and he's primarily citing his health concerns as a reason for this decision. It's a 3-page letter that Rajinikanth has penned, a very emotional letter, explaining the reasons as to why he's taken this decision. And he gives a background. He starts by talking about the filming of his movie Annate. He says, even though there were strict regulations and strict protocols that were put in place, 4 crew members had tested positive for COVID-19, after which Rajinikanth himself suffered a health scare. There were serious BP fluctuations and he was hospitalized, and detailed medical investigations were carried out by the Apollo hospitals in Hyderabad, and after which the doctors have advised him complete bed rest for 1 week, and they've also advised him to stay away from any activity that could cause problems for his health. So he cites all of that and he says, this is a message from God. This entire episode was a message from God. And he goes on to say that even if I launch a political party, he cannot do campaigning on media and on social media platforms, because that will not create the kind of political change that he wants in Tamil Nadu. That will not help his party in winning the election. So there is no point doing any campaigning on social media. And he again goes on to say that, even if a vaccine comes, he is someone who's taking immunosuppressant drugs. So again, there could be a possibility of, his health suffering a setback if at all he contracts COVID-19. And he says that, he does not want to create problems for the people who've also come along with him in this political journey. And he is seeking forgiveness from Rajinikanth fans and the functionaries of Rajini Makkal Mandiram. He, of course, says, whatever work you've done so far, that is great work, and the blessings will help you and your family. But I seek your forgiveness because, it is with great pain and grief that I'm making this decision. These are the words that Rajinikanth has mentioned in his letter. And he, of course, goes on to say the Rajini Makkal Mandiram will function as usual. And he's urging the people of Tamil Nadu and his fans especially to understand this decision that he has taken. So clearly a day of great disappointment as far as Rajinikanth fans are concerned. And there was a lot of speculation till today, about what decision Rajinikanth could make, because on December 31st was when he was expected to make an announcement regarding the dates of his party launch. But Rajinikanth, of course, took to Twitter today and said that he is not making that political plunge and he's not launching his political party. And what we're given to understand is that his family members were also extremely concerned about his health condition, and you know, they also advised him not to take any steps that could create problems for himself. And keeping all this in mind, Rajinikanth has taken this decision. But political observers in the state also say, you know, this is not just about his health. It's a combination of reasons. They've been calling him a reluctant politician. And several people doubted that Rajinikanth will actually take that political plunge. So many say that this was very much expected, backing out of sorts.
That's true.
Rajinikanth, of course, is citing his health reasons.
Right, Shilpa, I'm going to come back to you in just a minute. We're going to continue that conversation, especially about to get a sense of what the party functionaries, the party fans have to say. Stay with me. I want to go across to Mr. Arun Ram, who's a resident editor of the Times of India. Mr. Ram, thank you so much for speaking to Mirror Now and waiting patiently for us. Many people would say that this anti-climax was almost expected because Rajinikanth was never serious. He's always known he had health concerns. It was something he had even said when he said, oh, I'm going to make this announcement on the 31st. And this just raises a question about whether all of this was a grand build-up for nothing.
I wouldn't say that the anti-climax was unexpected. But then, you know, he has been a master of prolonging the suspense so much that the suspense itself lost its content. Because if you look at it, the last 3 years, first after he promised that he was going to enter politics, he went back on it or gave subtle messages that he may not enter politics. And this was the notion till maybe a couple of months ago that he might not again enter politics. And then suddenly a month ago, he came to the fore and said that he went on record saying that he's indeed going to launch the political party and the announcement is expected on 31st of December. So probably that was the turning point. Till then, people were not sure. But then after that, they were sure that he was going to. But nobody expected this turn of events in Hyderabad when he was shooting for a movie. Many people were taken ill, COVID-related, and then his blood pressure shot up. So I think health is finally the final reason why Rajinikanth decided not to enter politics. So that anticlimax was not expected. Probably the same result which we thought would happen 2 months ago has happened now. But in between, there were two climaxes and anticlimaxes. As I said, you know, it has been going on long in the suspense for a long time. Rajini, as a master of, you know, cinema, should know that it will take away the sting and the power and the metal from the political game. And finally, that is what has happened. It also goes on to show that Rajini might not be cut out for politics, something which many people, including me, have been saying, that by given the very nature of the man, he may not be fit for the rough and tumble of politics. Because for one, if you look at it, he has never taken criticism, with the boldness of a politician, with the thick skin of a politician, if I may say so. And he has never taken on leaders of other political parties till now. Probably he was delaying it to the launch of the party, and he may have realized that he's not cut out for the job. If you look at it, when Karunanidhi and Jayalalitha were alive, the only statement he made was in 96. And of course, now the statement he made that he's going to support the BJP government, but he said that his fans were free to vote for anybody. So he was a bit wishy-washy, ambivalent, vacillating, and vague in his political statements. But finally, when it came to taking a call, he did it under pressure. This also goes on to show that he made it under pressure from several quarters. He was under pressure to launch a party. He was also under pressure from several quarters not to launch a party. So finally, he took the plunge, but then he could not take the pressure so much that his blood pressure shot up. And I'm told that the doctors have advised him it's not worth taking the plunge because his system is just unable to take it. Because we have to keep in mind that Rajini is living with a donor kidney, and he is immunosuppressed. He has several health problems. He was trying to strike a balance between health and his political ambitions and what he thought was his political duty. Finally, the health has got the upper hand.
Well, Mr. Ram, obviously, Tamil Nadu, India, and all of us here wish him the best of health, but this decision is obviously also going to have some critics say, well, we always saw this coming, we told you so. But what does this mean for Tamil Nadu's political landscape? Well, Rajinikanth is very confident that he was going to win the elections itself. Obviously, some people saw him also as a prop of the BJP. BJP's silent hand pushing him or the support of the BJP. What does this do for specifically the BJP's game plan in Tamil Nadu?
I think the biggest loser here is the BJP, of course. Not to say that that Rajinikanth had agreed to BJP's plans. BJP has been pressuring Rajinikanth for a long time through its intermediaries to either support the BJP or take their support or form an alliance, which Rajini was not very keen on doing it, because that would sort of defeat the purpose of his, you know, his motto of being an alternative to the existing parties. I would say that the BJP's many of the plans have been dampened by Rajini's scooping the political scene. And the happiest people here would be the DMK and the AIADMK, because AIADMK, because there was a possibility of the BJP going with Rajini or supporting Rajini by deserting the AIADMK. Now, Edappadi Palaniswamy and company will be very happy that the BJP will have to play its B team in Tamil Nadu and will have to go by what it says, accepting EP as a chief ministership. DMK, on the other hand, would also be partying tonight because of the fact that they were worried what kind of votes, especially people who are waiting for an alternative, who would be the same electorate who might have voted against the government because of the 10 years of the anti-incumbency factor, would have gone to the DMK. So DMK and the AIADMK are clearly the beneficiaries out of today's development, and BJP is the loser, if we can call them so.
Well, Mr. Ram, thank you so much for speaking to Mirror Now. It's going to be an interesting few months now leading up to the elections. If I could just request you to stay with us some more, I want to go back to Shilpa, who's outside Rajnikant's residence now. Shilpa, there have also been some functionaries who have been appointed to key positions in Rajni's party. Are you getting a sense of what happens to them, whether they were consulted on this decision or not? Or was it something that even they're probably taken aback by?
Well, Aarti, they were very much consulted. In fact, yesterday, Rajnikant held a meeting with Tamilarvi Manian and Arjun Murthy. These are two individuals that Rajnikant had appointed to look into the party launch and other issues related to his political party launch. And they, of course, held a meeting. And we spoke to Tamilarvi Manian yesterday. And he, of course, said that a decision would be announced soon. He says that, you know, one should wait for Rajnikant to finally announce that. And even in his letter, Rajnikant has thanked Tamilarvi Manian and Arjun Murthy for standing alongside him in this journey. And he says that he's indebted to Tamilarvi Manian for saying that his health, Rajnikant's health, is what matters the most. Every other criticism that comes their way, it can be handled, but his health is what matters most. And Rajnikant has thanked Tamilarvi Manian for that as well. Of course, both of these individuals have not reacted publicly as of now regarding this decision that Rajnikant has put out, but definitely they were consulted because they were with him and they were looking into these party affairs, and they also held discussions with Rajnikant yesterday. As far as Gurumurthy is concerned, again, he is someone who was very, very instrumental in advising Rajnikant, and he has been seen as someone who is advising him what to do.
Right. Okay. Mr. Arun Ram, thank you so much for speaking to Mirror Now this afternoon. Shilpa, thank you so much for bringing us that perspective as well. We keep a close eye on the political landscape in Tamil Nadu and all the developments following Rajnikant's dramatic announcement that he has a sign from God and he's putting off his political plunge.